Dhivya, fourth quarter earnings much stronger than the street was expecting. That's why your stock is up almost 4% pre-market. When you look at the fourth quarter, do you look at this and say big improvement in terms of North America, but you have some concerns perhaps with China?
Yeah, Phil, strong results across the board for the quarter and for the year. And this was despite the challenges we faced from a commodity and FX perspective. Strength in North America, as you talked about. We still posted $2 billion of equity income in China for the year. And we had strength in GM Financial as well. And if you look at these different segments, I would say that North America was helped by our truck launch and the continued strength in our crossovers, as well as a laser focus on costs. And in China, our execution continues to be strong in a volatile environment. And in the fourth quarter, we were impacted more by our launch costs as well. We had $100 million of impact from our all new launches of vehicles coming up in 2019 that also impacted our results. But all of this points to the earnings resiliency of the company and the execution in a volatile environment.
I want to talk a little bit more about China, Dhivya, only because you guys are a great way of focusing so many people's attention on China and this question about whether or not the economy there is slowing down. Yes, you had the launch cost that impacted fourth quarter results. Your equity income was down about 33% fourth quarter over fourth quarter. How much of that do you look at as the launch cost, and how much do you look at it and say, look, we have a market here that is slowing down? I guess what we're trying to get an understanding of is what's happening with the Chinese economy.
I think if you look at China, obviously Q4 was a very volatile quarter, and we saw pressures from a volume and pricing perspective. In January, you're seeing signs of stabilization across a number of indicators. Early days, but we're keeping an eye on it. And there's also talk of stimulus that we're keeping an eye on. And if you look at our execution within that, we're constructive about the fact that we are in a very unique position in China. We have 20 years of market leadership. Our brands are very strong. And we have excellent launches coming up across all of our brands. And the strength of Cadillac, was up across the board about 20% year over year in 2018. In a declining market environment. So what we're focused on is what we can execute, and we are cautiously optimistic about the measures that are being talked about, but what we can control is our execution.
So just to be clear, just to put a button on this, you believe that the China market, to a certain extent, is stabilizing in terms of auto demand out there. While it may be lower, it is not falling off a cliff as some people have feared.
Yeah, our outlook in the China auto industry is for a flat industry year over year.
Real quick, I want to talk about what's happening in North America. You are idling a number of plants. You're in the process of shedding about 14,000 workers as you bring down your costs in North America. And yet there are some on Wall Street who look at your guys' capacity and they say they still have a little bit too much capacity, whether you look at the Fairfax plant out in Kansas City or you look at some of the other plants. Can you guarantee analysts right now that you have right-sized the business, that we will not see further cuts either in 2019 or 2020?
We have nothing new to announce today. The actions we announced in November were aimed at right-sizing that capacity. And you know, Phil, there's been a shift in demand from a passenger car towards crossover, and that's not new news. And the actions we took in November are necessary actions to position us for the long-term success of the company. Beyond that, I don't really have anything else to share today.
Quick snapshot of the U.S. Consumer. Are they continuing, from your perspective, to buy the trucks and the SUVs at the rate that you expect? Are you seeing any softness at all?
No, our outlook for our auto sales this year is low 17 millions total SAR. And what we see across the board is strong balance sheets from a consumer perspective. We have wage growth and unemployment at a constructive level, all of which point to a healthy U.S. economy. So we may be at a plateau, but it is a plateau at a pretty strong level. And we are seeing signs of continued demand, and the truck sales are going well. Our new truck launch has gone exceptionally well, and you're seeing that helping the results today, and we continue to see that into 2019.